here's another secret of photography gear.
Secret? Secret information. Secret that shouldn't be secret. Some of you people bought, like, that Voigtlander 58mm off my recommendation, and I get, like, an email from basically everybody, like, oh my god, this lens is incredible. It's made out of metal. It's pure perfection. It's really cheap. It's basically like a $1,000 lens for $500. Yeah. You know where you find Voigtlander ads at? Most of you never even heard of the damn company until I mentioned it to you. The lens is like buying a Rolls Royce for, you know, it's like going to a used car lot and there's like a Rolls Royce over there in the corner. And it's got like a sticker on it that says like 2000. It's like, is that a Rolls Royce for $2,000? Like, yes, it is. Here's the philosophy. You know, kind of additionally so. You ever know, you see like these guys from New Jersey? They like wearing the gigantic gold chains and the huge watches. And you know they ain't got no money. It's like every penny that they got is like tied up in that gold chain and that watch that they're wearing. At one point in time, I guess I could make fun of myself. I mean, I looked like a drug dealer rolling down the street because of all these tattoos, because I had a solid gold Rolex on that many times I thought I was going to get beat over the head for. That watch was worth a fortune. Still got it. It's in the back safe, actually. I still got that watch. Rolexes don't keep very good time if you don't wear them all the time. And then like a bright red BMW Z3 with chrome roll bars, and I would pull up and man, people would look over me driving that car and they go, drug dealer! No. If you looks like you got it, you probably don't got it. What does this have to do with camera gear? I'm getting to that very quickly. I know a few millionaires that have more money than all of you combined. I mean, they got so much money. One dude is a really awesome dude. Love him to death. He is rocking an old iPhone that is like older than dust. I forget which version of iPhone it is. And he is driving a car. Well, it's not a car. It's a SUV type. And that thing has got like a bazillion miles on it. It's always falling apart. The man could buy whatever he wants. And he doesn't wear a watch at all. He doesn't dress. I mean, I know several people like that. You roll up on them. The only people that actually dress flamboyantly with money are like people up in the Northeast. Not the only people. Well, actually, Russians and Eurotrash, like rich Eurotrash, loves to flaunt like, you know, their money. They'll like wear super expensive stuff. They look like they're, you know, running a fashion show. They're always, you know, showing you off their Gucci bag and stuff. These people that I know, a few of them, I mean, they got so much money. And they don't wear expensive clothes, and they drive old-ass cars, and people look at them, and they would think, oh, man, that person is broke. And then they'll shock someone. It's like, then they find out. And then they just, like, they do a double take. What does this have to do with camera gear? I know. I kind of went off on a tangent there. Camera gear. You notice how you never see an ad for Voigtlander? Yeah, you really don't see any advertising from Fuji. The people that know the good stuff, okay? Here's a tip. The one lens company that makes horrible lenses, they're absolutely, it sounds like a sick mother or sick mom. Yeah, this lens company that sounds like sick mom. Yeah. Their quality control is horrible. Their sample variation is horrible. The only reason that camera stores sell a lot of them is because their spiffs are the absolute highest. Spiff means commission. That lens has got a really high commission. And so when you're in a camera store, they're always trying to peddle you Sigma junk. Oh, I said the word. Excuse me. Horrible lenses. Just horrible. And if you open up a photography magazine, their ads are everywhere. Everywhere you go, advertise the hell out of their stuff. The reason for that, I mean, my God, they're advertising. All over the place. Advertising up the wazoo. And another company that makes cameras that overheat, and they have absolutely horrible, horrible customer service. They don't actually repair their own cameras. They have another company that repairs them, and their customer service is even more awful than the camera company. Horrible. Beyond horrible. I mean, astronomically bad. They're always advertising. It's kind of amazing the fact that the more horrible a company is, the more likely they are to bomb your face and eyeballs and ears with their stupid, stinking advertising. Most of you people never even heard of Voigtlander until I mentioned it to you. And then you got the lens, you're like, oh my God, this lens is incredible. It's made so well, and the images from it are just like from heaven. Yeah. Same thing with Fuji, really. Fuji does some advertising. Not that much. People that know, know. It's like, you don't quality. Here's the fact, and it's an old saying, I believe. I can't remember where it came from. It says, quality screams and trash flashes. If you want to remember something, remember that phrase. I don't know if I came up with it or if I heard it myself. Quality screams of its own accord, like this. This is like the Rolls-Royce of compasses. I actually do a lot of different stuff that I need a quality. This is like the Rolls-Royce of compass. I mean, it's very heavy, it's chrome-plated brass, it's made in Germany. It's just the shiznits. Quality screams. It's like when you know good quality stuff and you have half a brain, if not better, quality will scream to you. Trash has to flash. Trash is trash, and the only way that it sells itself is by flashing you like a dirty lecher. You know, it's like out in the Central Park, the dude that wears a raincoat and he goes, "Wow, look at this baby." They're always advertising their trash to you. Yeah, remember that phrase. Quality screams and trash flashes. And that ought to tell you something, because that one lens company and that other camera company, they are always, "Look at this baby, man, yeah, man, check this out." The quality is over there quietly, like sitting on the park bench, peeling an apple. And you can just see it just oozes refinement and perfection. It just oozes it. It drips it like a bee honeycomb dripping honey. It's like, man, I can see the quality right over there. It's quiet, it doesn't say anything. If you have half a brain, some people are just stupid. I mean, let's be honest. I know this is going to insult somebody, but some people are just morons. I mean, they'll just praise, like, it's like, man, this is awesome. It's like, you do know that's junk, right? Some people grew up not taking things apart. They're blind. I mean, they have eyeballs, but they're blind. They actually cannot recognize quality from trash. Like, I can give someone one of the highest quality lenses, even forgetting about the images, just how it's built. And they give them just like the cheap, it's like you squeeze it and it like makes a tinker toy. And it's like, wee, wee, and like one of the squeezy toys. It's like they can't even tell the difference in the quality. It's like, what's their quality? What do you think? Which one's the made the bed? It's like, I don't know. They're both kind of the same. It's like, are you kidding me? You're an idiot. I've run into people like that before. It's like, you really can't tell the difference between. I mean, some of these people, it's like if you put a Rolls-Royce or a BMW in front of them. And like one of those smart cars, beep beep. They were like, "What's the quality difference?" I'm like, "I don't know. They're probably about the same." It's like, really? That's a Rolls Royce. That's a BMW Rolls Royce. And over here is one of those death devices. One of those little smart cars. It's like 7 foot by 7 foot. It even makes a Volkswagen look like a tank. Like beep beep, beep beep. It's like, what's the quality? They just don't know. There are actually a lot of people out there like that, and they shock me. They shock me. It's kind of like if you were walking, but people like that are like someone walking around half naked wearing like a purple polka dot Speedo with their hot dog hanging out. I mean, it's like people go, "Oh my God, look at that." People like that shock me like that. It's like you really can't see the difference between this plastic turd made in China and this quality piece of precision made in Japan and Germany. No, they kind of look the same to me. It's like, oh, really? Were you being serious about that? Yeah, I'm being serious. Yeah, they're kind of the same. It's like, wow, man, you are like proof that society is doomed. Oh God, I love running into people like that. It's like riding a roller coaster. They're so unintelligent. They shock me. They're like, wow, damn, that's so stupid. That's like shocking, man. If like I had hair, it'd be blowing back right now. I'd be like, wow, man, that's so dumb.